Roger is like many boys. Meeting the school bus on time is a hard job. Why can't Mr. Crane, the driver, wait a minute until Roger is ready? Mr. Crane must pick up 30 boys and girls every weekday morning and bring them to school on time. He must watch the minutes carefully so he is not late at the next stop. He must check the gauge to be sure he has enough gasoline to get the bus to the end of the line. He must watch the dial to know he is going at the right speed. Besides driving and taking care of 30 children, Mr. Crane uses addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division to help him do his job. They are all part of the mathematics we use every day to help us through a happy and useful life. Roger and his friend Mike eat lunch together in the school cafeteria. They each bring 50 cents to pay for their food. Today, Mike bought the regular luncheon tray, while Roger bought his things in the short order line. Mike's tray has a meat patty, corn, a small salad, and a carton of milk, all things a growing boy needs. If he had bought these things separately, it would have cost Mike 60 cents. But by getting them on the regular tray, they cost him only 50 cents. Roger, on the other hand, bought only three things. He thought his lunch would cost him 50 cents also, but he was mistaken. Now he must borrow 5 cents or return some of the food. It's not only important for us to know how to add and subtract correctly, but learning how to figure value received can bring us more and better things in life. Roger and his friends are building a clubhouse in Roger's backyard. It's nearly finished, and the boys are proud of it. Everything has gone fine until the last board is ready to be nailed to the building. What happened? One of the boys made a mistake when he sawed the lumber. He subtracted quickly in his mind and took 3 inches from 10 instead of 12, the length of 1 foot. Over at the door, the boys find that because of a wrong measurement, their table will not go through the opening. You see how easy it is to lose time as well as materials when you don't know your measurement tables. Studying mathematics will help you not only right now, but in whatever you choose as your life work later on. There was big news down at Henry's bicycle shop last week. A new shipment of bikes just arrived, and the one on display was just what Roger wanted. but there seemed to be two prices. Roger had saved enough money to buy a bicycle, but his dad had always told him to be sure to look for the best value. Should he spend $45 at one time, or only $5 each month until the bike is paid for? By using papers representing $5 bills, Roger's dad shows him that $5 each month for 10 months, plus $5 for the down payment, makes a total of 11 $5 bills for the bicycle. If he pays $45 in full payment, he will have paid a total of 9 $5 bills. One way, the bike will cost $10 more than the other. By using mathematics, Roger has learned that it costs extra money to buy things on time. That is, paying a small amount each month over a long period. When school is over for the day, Roger and his friends like to go to the corner store for a refreshing drink. Each of the boys buys a different flavor, and when they get together, there's quite a group of bottles and cans. Each boy has spent 10 cents, but it seems some of them got more to drink than others. They decide to check the labels to see just how much each contains. This one has 14 ounces. Another only 8 ounces. Here's one containing 12 ounces. And this big one has a full pint of refreshment. How many ounces are in one pint? Roger learned in school last year that a pint is 16 ounces. By figuring the other containers, the boys learn that while they each paid the same money for their drink, they didn't get the same amount. When buying most things, it pays to know your mathematics to be sure of getting the best value. You use mathematics whenever you count days on the calendar or minutes on the clock, when you sell papers or keep score at the ball game. If you plan to help build rockets or try new recipes, all your life you will need to know how to use numbers. Only a good understanding of mathematics can help us meet the problems that face all of us every day. It can help us figure the best value when there is a choice, and help us spend our money wisely. Yes, many things can be done better when we know our mathematics.